What's up, Foxtrotters? Welcome back to the channel. Thank you so much for tuning in. If you're new here, welcome, welcome. If you're returning, hello. It's so nice to see you all again. You guys look great. So I just wanted to say, of course, I need to be annoying and say thank you to everyone so much. We've crossed over, I believe last I checked, over 330 subscribers. And I just, wow. I don't even know what else to say other than just thank you. And I'm going to just keep bringing you the content you guys are wanting. And so today, we're going to do r/anti-MLM. Yay! I hope you're excited. I am. I think this one's going to be pretty good. So that sounds interesting to you. Please stay tuned. Okay, so for this very first post, I figured that the husbands needed a little redemption, okay? I don't know if you remember, but it was either my last video or the video before, but I had a picture of a consultant who had checked a box on their MLM checkout page. I'm not sure which one it was. It was like LuLaRoe or Mary Kay, one of those. And it essentially was one of the boxes you could check that says, tell your husband this was a free gift so he doesn't question you, you know, that type of thing. And I just thought that was so trashy to just encourage people to lie to their partners, just trash. So I saw this and I was like, oh, this is good. This makes me feel good. LuLaRoe going out of business sale, or in quotations, my husband is making me sell it sale. Well done, sir. It's a win for all LuLaRoe husbands everywhere. You know, all those husbands who had to stand in those horrible boutiques with their wives and take photos like they actually enjoyed what they were doing. I mean, they deserve some real credit for that. And I hope that they're able to go on a vacation with the money that they get from that LuLaRoe stuff. But let's be real, they probably won't. So my mom started working with Herbalife about 2 years ago. She's gotten so attached to it that she neglected me. She claims to have tons of money, but we had to move out of our house because she couldn't afford it. I feel bad for people who look up to my mom, and the fact that the mom is in quotation says a lot about the nature of the relationship, and based on that, I will read the mom's comment here, or her post, in the Hunbot voice. It feels right.
If you know me at all, then you know that I love Herbalife, right? I'm so excited about our new challenge starting tomorrow. I'm excited about the next 90 days on my plan. I'm just excited about the future. And because I'm so excited, I want to share a little something special with y'all. Drop a little emoji or DM me for more deets on what I'm talking about. And yes, it's only good for tonight. And in all honesty, do you think I would be talking about something so much if I didn't believe in it? Y'all know me better than that. Lol. You cannot currently be working underneath another coach to receive offer.
Okay. That's really sad. But what I like about it is the comment below. This is why Reddit is great, okay? The comment below right here is from another poster who's had a similar experience, and it's great. My mom is in too. She sells Prove It. She's had money problems my whole life through, so I learned how to not handle money from her. She just recently decided to quit her 10-year full-time job so she could sell keto drinks full-time. Dear God. I get how you feel. I've barely talked to my mom since she started it, and we used to talk every day. It definitely feels like it changes them into a different person entirely. I'm sorry for your situation. Oh, me too. I am also sorry for your situation. I'm sorry for all of your situations. You know, I love my mom so much, and if she did this to me, I think my heart would just break, you know, I can't imagine. So I'm sorry, people, but you know what? This is why Reddit is great. This is why it's awesome, because you can come on here and just anonymously talk and find people who have been through what you've been through and find a community. That is why it is wonderful. And even though this is kind of sad in a way, I feel like better about it. You know, having a support system, having a support group can get you through a lot. It really can. So. But I'm sorry your mom sucks. Both of you. Sorry both of your moms suck. At least right now. rodan+fields preying on adoptive parents. Oh God, brace yourselves. Top 10 reasons why adoptive parents should say yes to aren't. I'm so mad at that. Oh, I hate it. Garbage. Shame on you, rodan+fields. That is so... Ooh, I want to cuss so bad right now. I want to cuss. I'm not going to. I want to so freaking bad. Oh my God. You guys. I don't even need to explain this, right? Like, this is... Ooh, that's next level. That's next level. Okay, one of you mentioned that I should cover rodan+fields, and I think they might have just sealed their fate. Ooh. Ooh. I'm coming for them. Yeah, I'm going to do a whole video on these people, on this company. This is nasty. Well, that last post really just ticked me off. So this whole rest of this video is going to have kind of an angry tinge to it. And of course, this one, young freaking living in the middle of a disabilities expo, trying to claim what? What? Lemon essential oil can make you walk again? Oh my God. No. Oh, how can that person standing there pouring out those oils to that woman in that chair, how can that person actually sleep at night? How can they let the words come out of their mouth? How can they eat lunch knowing what they've done? Oh. Oh, I'm so angry right now. It's rising. I need to calm down. We're going to move on. We're going to move on. We're moving on. Oh, good. More proof of excellent weight loss. This is going to work for sure. I can tell already. This is my girl's results. She lost... Oh, I should be doing this in the robot voice, huh? This is my girl's results. She lost almost 6 pounds on my 2-day gentle herbal cleanse. I'm looking for 6 people to try this out. That little bit of belly fat that just won't seem to go away no matter what you try, it's not fat, it's toxins. Our guts can carry anywhere from 5 to 25 pounds of sludge. The result? Acne, fatigue, headaches, sickness, and that stubborn bloat. Not to mention this douchey voice. This is not one of those crazy, harsh, week-long juice cleanses. Comment favorite emoji below. See, robots love emojis too, my dudes. Robots love emojis. Look at that little sparkly heart and a watermelon slice. Cool, man. Cool, bro. And I'm not sure the top photo... is a picture of a pair of feet. I don't get that. I don't know if his feet are supposed to look less veiny, more veiny, or if, I don't understand. I don't know if those are her feet. I can't tell. But the photo of her, you guys, she's even wearing the same freaking shirt. And her pants are rolled the exact same way, okay? I wear my sweatpants the same way because they're too long and I roll them up just like that. And You're telling me 2 days later you put on the exact same outfit and your hair was even on that same side of your body? Get out of here. You're just sucking it in and sticking your butt out. We all know it. Everyone knows it. You know it. You didn't lose any weight from that. And that's fine. You look great the way you are. And your boyfriend is a jerk anyways for using you in this and making you think that you need to lose belly fat or whatever. That can't be healthy for your psyche. Wow, I'm angry today, you guys. Hold on, I'm really going to try to calm down. I'm going to really try. So I did already read through this one, but I'm glad I did because I was initially going to read the Hunbot's portion in the Hunbot voice that I do, but after reading it, I decided against it because she's just actually looking for information. So I'm not gonna disrespect her like that when she's asking some legit questions, so... If I only sell one lash boost this month, is it worth filling up my own sales volume to try and get a commission? I can't really spend $80 this month and I don't need anything. I can never seem to figure out if it's worth getting paid, then I end up spending $100 to get a $30 commission. And then below that, the comments, my upline would say it's worth it. My personal opinion, it's not worth it. I've had months like that and it just doesn't add up for me. And then the next person below, your upline says it's worth it because of how it affects her buckets. I don't fill my buckets unless my 600 is going to be full. And I don't know what the heck that means, buckets. But I'm assuming that has something to do with the structure of the pyramid. You got to make sure that, you know, the 6 below you and the 6 below them or whatever, they're all getting their quota to make sure that you get that money that trickles up or whatever. Maybe that's what that means, but either way, no, it's not worth it. And I mean, I'm glad you asked the question, person, but you seem like you're a little naive and that's okay. A lot of us are. It's normal. But no, that is never worth it. And, you know, one day you'll realize that. So I hope.
I can't even stress the importance of a daily detox and monthly cleanse. It's so good for your GI health and reduces your bloating slash ability to actually lose weight easier. Clink. I'll stand behind these for life. Plus, this fat-burning coffee is just fire hot, and making easy lifestyle swaps for energy just makes sense. Just sharing how bomb this combo is.
And then the arrow down to show her incredible dramatic transformation. Amazing. Wow. Incredible. So incredible that she tinted her walls from white to beige. That's what happens when you are doing such a good job on your weight loss program. Your walls will actually change color. It's incredible. Wearing the same outfit, same pair of shorts, also rolled up the same. You're clearly pushing your tummy out in the first one, and you're clearly sucking it in the second one, but okay, yeah, yeah, no, you totally, it's an incredible transformation. I'm so happy for you. I'm so happy. So I am going to read this one in the Hanbot voice, but the text overlaid onto the color background and some of the other editing that's been done makes it kind of hard to like see it as I'm reading through. My eyes are like playing tricks on me. Maybe that's because I'm getting older. I don't know. I can't tell. We're not going to talk about that right now.
So my friend who does lip fillers was telling me that they now inject hyaluronic acid into the lips for the fillers. Hyaluronic acid is something your body naturally produces to keep your skin plump and hydrated, to keep us looking youthful. We also produce less and less as we age. I'm not into injections, but I love the sound of more hyaluronic acid in my body to keep me looking young. That's why I drink this.
Okay. How much hyaluronic acid are you drinking? And are you implying it's going to go plump up your lips? Because lip injections are pretty specific. Lip injections are to make your lips go, you know, whatever. If you're into that, whatever. That's cool. You want to spend your money on that? Whatever. That's your thing. I think your lips look great the way they are, whoever you are. But if you want lip fillers, well, freaking go for it. You're an adult. But they're implying that drinking this will be similar to getting lip injections. I don't think so. I don't think you're going to get similar results from drinking something as you would from like a small surgical procedure. But like, what do I know, right? Very little, apparently. But I don't know. And let that water, that drink, whatever she's drinking. Like, I like green juice. I drink all those weird green smoothies. I think they're good. But like, I don't know, these MLM concoctions, just all of them, I just assume all of them just make you spend a lot of time in the bathroom. I don't know. I'll just do the hyaluronic acid like in the face cream. I have a face cream with that in there, and that feels good. I feel good about that. I don't think I need to drink that crap. Gratitude. Obviously, I had a disgust for MLMs before I came here, and I didn't even have a name to slap on what my friend was doing to me a little while back. Like pestering me to sell Avon with her and literally bought me a starter kit. After 4 months of saying, I don't want to do that, now I have an Avon starter kit in storage. She has 3 young children, and the words,
I'm just trying to stay at home with the kids by profiting off my Avon business and reading tarot for people, have slipped out of her mouth.
I shuddered. I wished her luck and actually couldn't talk to her for a while, in the midst of ignoring Avon sales and whatever. I literally fell for another MLM thing. I bought a rodan+fields regimen, ooh, there they are again, before I found the sub through another friend. I have severe acne and it was easy to pull me in. Now I've canceled my subscription with them and have seen a dermatologist. I'm a part of a ton of anti-MLM things, and it is because of this sub. This group is God's work. More knowledge about this crap needs to be spread, and I think its tendrils of truth are creeping into more minds on the daily. So thanks for being public and for all the people posting here all the time. The more you know.
Ding, ding.
Yes. You know, and as for God's work, you know, I don't know about all that. I don't know if we dare take that credit, but like, thank you. I do agree this knowledge needs to be spread, and that's kind of what got me started with this whole thing, is I just feel like there needs to be more of this, more people talking about it, because people fall prey to this all the time. I had a friend who bought Proactive for years in high school. I mean, they were on like a monthly subscription, and at one point she showed me, she opened a closet and they had stacked full, one closet, like a linen closet, stuffed full of just Proactive boxes of her particular skincare regimen. And it's like, what are you doing? what is that all that doing here? And it's like, even then I thought that was strange, but you know, I figured, oh, you know, well, you'll never have acne again. But like, she did, and it never actually went away, and turned it, it was like actually a hormonal thing, and Proactive would do nothing to help with that, because hormonal stuff you have to take medication for. You can't just rub stuff on your face and hope it's gonna work. So yeah. Well, I am also grateful for this Reddit, this subreddit as well. It has been really fun and interesting, and I feel good about getting the information out there. I feel like it's bringing a lot of people together, and I really like that. So more of that. Let's do more of that, and less of purchasing skin regimens from Rodan and Fields. Yeah? Yeah. And for the obligatory cute animal photo today, it is River lounging on her cat tower, enjoying an afternoon nap slash hangout, if you will. And just so everyone's aware, I know that that plant hanging up in the top left is a shamrock plant. I did move it because, I mean, it's been hanging there forever and she has never expressed interest in it before. And I know they're toxic. Well, the other day she surprised me by trying to give it a few chews. So it has since been moved. Don't worry. Anyways, if anyone's looking to get a new member of their family, new love of their life, I highly recommend to adopt and not shop. Check out your local shelters, your local humane societies. Donate if you can, volunteer if you can, and don't forget to spay and neuter your pets. All right, Fox Trotters, that's going to do it for me today. Thank you so much for tuning in. If you liked that video, please hit that like button down below. I know that was a little bit more of an angrier video than normal. That Rodan and Fields thing really just set it off for me. Sometimes that happens. Anyway, if you have any good comments or suggestions, please feel free to leave that down below as well. If you are not already, please hit that subscribe button and become a Fox Trotter. I would appreciate it so very, very much. And as always, folks, until the next video, take care.